bubbles. Look at them coming. Right, are they supposed to walk down the aisle? Probably aren't. There they go. There they go.
It may be overused, but there's a lighthouse reference here, of course. So lighthouses are beacons of light for people, and when you think about marriage, and you, thanks, Rob. And when you think about marriage, and you think about the friends and the people in your lives, each one serves really as a beacon, as a light, especially in marriage and friendship. When I look around here and I see the people that are around you, the lights that have gathered for today, I'm very confident in your future. It's beautiful to see. Andy and Leslie did not get here by themselves today, without the love and nurturing of their families. I ask now, who presents this woman to be wed here today?
Her mother and I do.
And you do this willingly. not too willingly now. Love is not something to be taken easily. neither is marriage. And part of what we come here to witness today is taking that Leslie and Andy from their engagement to marriage. You have to respect marriage. It is not, it's a commitment, and commitments are not easy to keep all the time. And what I encourage is your patience, like all commitments, like all things that you desire and you work hard towards. It requires your patience, your dedication, your persistence to make it work. No matter the best or worst that life is going to give you, like this beautiful day here, it's all transient, except for love. And as long as you nurture that, that goes on forever. So I will ask, Leslie, do you come here freely and without reservation to give yourself to Andrew? If so, answer, I do. She said yes. Andrew, do you come here freely, without reservation, to give yourself to Leslie in marriage? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
Wait willingly. I now ask you to declare marriage vows to each other. As you stand with facing each other and hold hands, Leslie, please repeat after me. I, Leslie.
I, Leslie.
Take you, Andrew.
Take you, Andrew.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or poor.
For richer or poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
In joy and in sorrow.
To love and to
cherish, and to be faithful to you alone, as long as we both shall live. Andy, repeat after me, please. I, Andrew,
take you, Leslie,
to be my wife,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
for better or for worse,
for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health,
in
joy and in sorrow,
and
to be faithful to you alone,
as long as we both shall live.
Excellent. The bride and groom have some vows that they would like to share with each other. Not only will I pass the microphone, I will also pass these vows. Those are directions.
No secret that we've been racing to this day since the first night we met. In 24 hours, you changed my life and have given me everything I ever wished for and laid awake at night wanting to find. I'm so grateful for you. Andrew Scott Reagan, I vow to always take my financial health seriously. I need it. I vow to always be honest with you. I vow to never shut you out when I'm mad, whether it's out of the house or out of my heart. I vow to never slam a car door again. I vow to always push your travel boundaries so that you can join me on the adventures of life that I've been so blessed to have so far. I vow to never start treating every date we ever have like it's our first date, because I know it's really easy to find love, but it's really hard to keep love. I vow to support you and to always be your best friend, but most of all, I promise to love you for all of eternity. For all of the rivers and rocks that it took me to get here, I would never want to be anywhere else than where I'm standing right now. And I'm excited for every adventure that we're going to have in the future. I love you.
Leslie? Life can change in a moment, and mine did. I had no idea how significant that moment was when you swiped right into my life. Your presence has started a great adventure. You have given a breath to my life and a brace to my back. You are the reason I plant a garden. You are the reason I have a balcony to
watch the sunset.
There cannot be a better person to have by my side on this journey. Leslie, I love you with all that is me, and I'm very proud and happy to be here today. In front of so many friends and family, in this moment, committing our lives to each other, I am a lucky man. Leslie, from this day forward, I vow to be the turtle to your shell, to be the right half of your pretzel, to be your driver through the mountain passes of life. I vow to share my life, my heart, and my soul with you, to be your lover and your best friend, to give you space and to hold you close. I vow to live for me and you equally, to no longer dream for me, but to now dream for us. I vow to walk with you through the challenges and to be the arms that hold you when times are tough. I vow to be with you as long as I am with this world. Finally, I vow to stay the person you fell in love with and to work hard to become a better man than the one who stands before you today. You are my love, you are my dream, and that is now true.
If anyone has Kleenex, please. At this moment, the bride and groom have asked for their friends to join in a moment of silent meditation, or as we're going to do, we're going to take a couple of selfies up here. So feel free to snap a few.
We're having a little break. Take pictures, all
That's funny.
I'd invite you all to smoke, but you know that's not allowed.
Your wedding rings are the outward visible sign of an inward, invisible bond that already unites the two of you. Your best man is going to present the rings. Andy, you're going to go first. Andrew, place the ring on Leslie's finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring. Wear it with love and joy.
Wear it with love and joy.
As this ring has no end,
as this ring has no end,
my love is forever.
My love is forever.
It's so nice.
Leslie, place the ring on Andrew's finger and repeat after me. With this ring, I marry you. Wear this ring forever as a sign of my love. May the wedding rings you exchange today remind you that always you are surrounded by enduring love. May your life together be blessed with prosperity and good wealth and health. I misread that. May you always share an open and honest communication with each other. May you respect each other's individual talents and gifts and give full support to each. May you cherish the home and family you will create together. May all the years come to be filled with moments to celebrate and renew your love such as today. May your love be a lifelong source of excitement, contentment, affection, respect, and devotion to one another. Now, by the power vested in me by the state of California and as a reverend of the Universal Life Church, it is my honor and delight to declare you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. You ready for this? I didn't want to interrupt.
Hey, by the way, sorry about TCU, guys. I was cold.
Oh, I didn't know it was
real! Ta-da! Oh, yeah. I was trying to get the reaction shot.
You gotta get backwards.
Here we go. No, first one like this. I now want like this. And you sure you don't want to micromanage my arm and back? We're good. All right.
All right.
I am pleased to present your newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Andrew Regan.
Thank you.